this is being used in a different way. It's got a double hose regulator rather than a single hose regulator. So you can see the Trieste II regulator up there with the double hoses. I have an octopus on it. So this is the octopus. And submersible pressure gauge right here with the depth gauge. There's the pressure gauge and shows the depth gauge and compass. And this is consistent with the Nautilus itself. The Nautilus comes with the inflator. This is the regulator for the Nautilus. It's a very good little piece that keeps the pressure equalized during the dive. So I can add air and subtract air, but to add air, I've got to use a double approach here. This is right here. Water intake valve. I've got to open that, and then I've got to push this lever up right here that opens this piece right here, which is the overpressure relief valve. Because this is a hard case, it acts like a submarine. Okay, I'm ready to dive, and you can see I've got the Nautilus on. Thing there. I'm gonna put the hoses over my head here. There we go. You can see they're super flex so that I can get them in my mouth easily.
I'm preparing for my dive at this point. Fins, mask, so on going on. And you can see I'm wearing just a little bit of weight, 10 pounds of weight, and then the other weight is 16 pounds, which is in the weight chute of the Nautilus. So I've got a total of 26 pounds of weight with my wetsuit. I've been diving a dive buoy for quite some time. This is a precaution just so the lifeguards will know where I'm at. The lifeguards are downstream of me. It looks like nothing's happening here, but what I'm doing is flooding the Nautilus. Once I've completely flooded it and gotten all of the air out, then I can submerge. At this point, I'm underwater, going with the current towards a marker tree. We'll see that tree coming up in just a moment. There it is. This is an area just, and you can see the current's pretty good there. Now, the flows above me are different from the flows here, and you can see there's quite a current here, and you can see my exhalation bubbles are being churned around. Now I'm going underneath a side current. This is a rapid that's over the top of me, and I'm going 90 degrees to that with a current that's 90 degrees to the rapid that's above. Have a depth gauge that's not reading any depth whatsoever. So that needs to be fixed. About ready to surface on the dive. I'm going to be doing some surface work, but you can see the current is pulling me pretty good still. Everything's looking upside down because this is a helmet-mounted camera, and with it mounted on my helmet, sometimes I'm looking backwards underneath myself, like right now. I'm on the surface and I'm going to be doing something here that you don't do with many other scubas.
Okay, this is something you can't do very often with the double.
I'm swimming on my back.
Without a free flow. I've got the Nautilus completely blown with air. The ballast is out, the water ballast, and so I'm floating very high.
Now I'm going to ditch the Nautilus, take it off completely. It's called a doff and don exercise, but this is done in open water, water too deep to stand in, so the Nautilus will be floating by itself in just a moment. Where my breathing hose is going over my head. Got caught on the camera, actually. There we go. The two-hose regulator is not free-flowing at all, and this is because the regulator is out of the water, being held up by the Nautilus. Now, in just a moment, I'll go through the process of putting the unit back on, which is donning the unit. I now have the Nautilus in a vertical position because I've flooded it a little bit. I've opened the water intake valve and I've opened the overpressure relief valve to allow some water to come in so that it is now vertical. And then I put the hoses over my head and now I'm getting into the straps.
Thank you.
flooded the Nautilus, and I'm on my descent down back down to the bottom. And once I got to the bottom, then I have to open the water intake valve and then add some air to gain neutral buoyancy again. Once I've done that, I can swim for long periods of time without changing anything, because the Nautilus is a constant volume. Difference in the noise levels for my bubbles, because I've just switched to my single hose regulator and the bubbles are coming up beside the camera instead of behind me off the Nautilus. This is the difference between a single hose and a double hose regulator. Back on the Nautilus Trieste, double hose regulator, and it's time to end the dive. I hope you've enjoyed my Nautilus dive. This is a unique unit that I've enjoyed learning how to dive.